In this video, the ice sheets change process in the Northern Hemisphere during the Ice Age and the relationship with hominin habitats at each period are displayed on a map and introduced. An ice age refers to a specific period when the ice sheets in the southern and northern hemispheres expanded. So, by this definition, the present is a climatologically ice age due to the presence of ice sheets in Greenland and Antarctica. In the last 500 million years of Earth's history, there have been at least 4 ice ages. However, even within the ice age, there were times when the weather was hot, and there were times when it was cold. The colder episodes are called glacials, and the warmer periods between the ice ages due to the retreat of continental glaciers are called interglacials. The first ice interglacial cycle was 41,000 years, but after 1 million years, the cycle slowed down to 100,000 years. I will introduce the ice age cycle through another video. In this video, based on the papers, the configuration of northern hemisphere ice sheets through the quaternary, and climate effects on archaic human habitats and species successions published in Nature Communications. I will introduce the changes in the Northern Hemisphere ice sheet and the changes of human habitation over time. We are now living in the fourth ice age, Quaternary Glaciation. As the Pliocene began 5.3 million years ago, Antarctica gradually began to freeze, and the Quaternary Glaciation started in earnest about 2.58 million years ago. Before the Quaternary Glaciation, temperatures were 2 to 3 degrees Celsius higher than now, and the global sea level was 25 meters higher. At this time, a bipedal Australopithecus lived in eastern and southeastern Africa, only about 1.2 m tall. Through various studies, including mitochondrial DNA analysis, this ape was found to be a direct ancestor of the genus Homo. From 3.59 million years ago, the Earth gradually cooled, and the northern hemisphere began to freeze, creating an ice sheet. This period is called the Late Gauss-Kron. At this time, the Earth's magnetic field reversed. Greenland was covered with a broader ice sheet than it is now. Even in North America, the Laurentide ice sheet and Cordilleran ice sheets are starting to grow. In Europe, parts of Norway and Sweden were covered by ice sheets. Ireland and parts of Scotland also had ice sheets at this time. Islands in the Barents and Kara Seas were also covered with ice. Australopithecus afarensis, popularly known as Lucy, lived in northeast Africa. Lucy is believed to be the common ancestor of the extant genus Homo. Lucy would have had to adapt to the cold with the start of the Quaternary Glaciation. As the transition from the Pliocene to the Pleistocene around 2.6 million years ago, Earth became cooler, drier, and more seasonal. It is during this time that Homo habilis first appears. Homo habilis is generally accepted as the ancestor of Homo ergaster or Homo erectus. Their fossils were discovered in 1964 in Olduwa Gorge in Serengeti National Park, Tanzania. They used sophisticated stone tools. Australopithecus and Homo habilis may have shared habitat in East Africa for over 600,000 years. At that time, the climate was 4 to 5 degrees Celsius cooler than today. During this time, the Laurentide, the Fennoscandinavia, and the Barents Kara ice sheet in the northern hemisphere doubled in size. Around 1.9 million years, Homo ergaster also appeared. Homo erectus, known to have been the first to use fire about 1.7 million years ago, also was born. They likely lived in Africa for some time, sharing the same habitat. There were early expansions of hominins out of Africa even before Homo sapiens migrated out of Africa and into the prehistoric world. Homo erectus was the first hominin outside of Africa. According to a paper published in Nature in April 2021, it is reported that the suitability of the habitat in the area where Homo habilis and Homo ergaster lived has deteriorated. On the screen, a dark color indicates a high fit and a light color indicates a low fit. This is also profoundly related to Pleistocene climate change. From the late Pleistocene onwards, the glacial period comes every 100,000 years. This period coincides with the emergence of Homo heidelbergensis. The origin of Homo heidelbergensis is East Africa. Some of these people left Africa and went to Europe. Neanderthals evolved from Homo heidelbergensis, which went to Europe. Homo sapiens evolved from Homo heidelbergensis, which remained in Africa. For 800,000 years, Earth's average temperature was 5 degrees C lower than today. Northern Hemisphere glaciers did not change significantly during this period, except for a slight enlargement of the Fennoscandinavian ice sheet. 700,000 years ago, the temperature became warm during an interglacial period. However, 677,000 years ago, the temperature dropped again and a glacial period came again. This glacial period lasted up to 622,000 years. During this time, the glaciers were greatly enlarged to the extent that the Fennoscandinavian and Barents Kara ice sheets merged. The European ice sheet covered all of Poland. Belarus was also almost covered with glaciers. Glaciation has also progressed from Russian provinces to the eastern border of Ukraine. In Siberia, the ice sheet expands to the point where it completely covers Russia's Krasnoyarsk province. Homo heidelbergensis and Homo erectus lived in Europe. According to a paper published in Nature, habitat suitability in Europe, where Homo heidelbergensis lived simultaneously, was reported to have deteriorated significantly. This thesis indirectly tells us that they all had to overcome the severe cold. 622,000 years ago, the Earth warmed up again and entered an interglacial period. Since then, the Earth's temperature has gone up and down little by little. Then, around 477,000 years ago, the glacial period began again. Scholars estimate that Neanderthals were born in Europe around this time. At the Guado San Nicola site in Italy, Neanderthal remains dating up to 400,000 years ago have been unearthed. Around this time, Britain was covered mainly by glaciers. In Europe, at the same time, Homo erectus, Homo heidelbergensis, and Neanderthal likely shared habitats. 365,000 years ago, the Earth cooled again, 3 degrees Celsius lower than the Holocene average temperature and 4 degrees Celsius lower than current temperatures. The lowest temperature was around 337,000 years ago. However, it was 1 to 2 degrees Celsius higher than the previous glacial period. Hominin habitats in Europe may have expanded during this time. 330,000 years ago, the interglacial period started. And 279,000 years ago, the Earth started to cool again. The glacial period lasts until 243,000 years before the present. The size of the glacier was similar to that of previous ice ages. The Laurentide and the Cordilleran ice sheet of North America were not interconnected. Looking at the remains of Neanderthals excavated at this time, it can be assumed that their habitats spread to the north and east. In Europe, Homo heidelbergensis, Homo erectus, and Neanderthal would have shared habitats. The Neanderthals' intelligence and ability to adapt to climate were superior to those of other hominins who lived simultaneously, which may have strengthened their habitat dominance. Around this time, Homo sapiens emerge. The remains of the oldest Homo sapiens, dating from 349 to 281,000 years ago, have been unearthed at Jebel Irhoud in Morocco. In addition, the remains of Homo sapiens who lived during this period have been found in Tanzania, Ethiopia, and South Africa. They have thrived in Africa and have not emerged outside Africa yet. After 243,000 years, the climate rose again, bringing it closer to the average Holocene temperature. There was a period when it got cold again around 230,000 years ago, but it would not have been much different from the present Earth. The interglacial period lasted until 190,000 years ago. There are only a few Homo heidelbergensis living in Europe at this time. Also, no Homo erectus remains have been excavated in Europe since 650,000 years ago. Although no Homo erectus was excavated in Asia at the same time, they must have survived in Asia as there are remains that lived until around 100,000 years ago. Neanderthals occupied interglacial Europe. They have made inroads into Central Asia. Denisovans most likely appeared at this time. Homo sapiens still lived mainly in Africa. Some of these groups made their way out of Africa into the Levant and the Balkans, but did not pass their genes on to modern humans. After the interglacial period ended 190,000 years ago, the glacial period started again. This was when the European ice sheet was at its most significant expansion. the glacial period lasted up to 132,000 years. The habitats of the Neanderthals who lived in Europe were also significantly reduced. The Fennoscandinavian ice sheet has expanded to the middle reaches of the Dnieper. Two-thirds of the Netherlands is covered with glaciers. A paper published in Nature also shows that their suitable habitat moved south to the Mediterranean coast. It must have been a tough time for them. You will find on the screen that the Neanderthal habitats of this period are concentrated in the Iberian Peninsula. For Homo sapiens living in Africa, climate change may have deteriorated their habitat. The climate would have become drier, and food would not have been plentiful. Some of these people left Africa and went to Asia for better conditions. The glacial period was the third event in the late Pleistocene when sea levels fell below 100 meters. Unfortunately, they couldn't pass on their genes to modern humans either. Perhaps we have yet to discover it remains intact genes. A warming period began 117,000 years ago. The North American and European ice sheets are mostly retreating. It is thought that some of the Homo sapiens attempted to move out of Africa around this time. Some of the Y chromosome haplogroup CF group set off for another world. In the case of maternal lineage, people belonging to mitochondrial DNA L3 searched for other worlds outside of Africa. For more information on this, please see the linked videos. Their out of Africa procession does not represent the birth of Homo sapiens, but all migration. The linked video shows the expected migration route through genetic tracing inherited from the common ancestor of modern humans. The Earth gradually warmed, and by about 100,000 years ago, most of the European ice sheet had melted. Also, much of the North American continental ice sheet, except for Greenland, melted. Around this time, Homo sapiens from Africa arrived in the Levant. It is challenging to distinguish Homo heidelbergensis clearly, but the presumed ancestors of Homo sapiens arrived in Asia early. The hominins that dominated Europe were still Neanderthals. Then, between 86,000 and 92,000 years ago, it was cooled, and the glacier expanded. And then, between 72,000 and 86,000 years, the temperature rose slightly, and the glacier retreated. During this period, I mapped the habitats of Neanderthals and Homo sapiens. From the year 72,000, the Earth's temperature starts to drop suddenly. The cooling period extends to 58,000 years ago. This coincides precisely with the catastrophic supervolcano eruption that occurred 74,000 years ago in Lake Toba, Sumatra, Indonesia. It is one of the Earth's largest known explosive eruptions. The Toba catastrophe theory holds that this event caused a global volcanic winter of 6 to 10 years and possibly a 1,000-year-long cooling episode, leading to a genetic bottleneck in humans. In 1993, science journalist N. Gibbons posited that a population bottleneck occurred in human evolution about 70,000 years ago, and she suggested that the eruption caused this. According to the genetic bottleneck theory, human populations sharply decreased between 50,000 and 100,000 years ago to 3,000 to 10,000 surviving individuals. Studies have shown that genetic bottlenecks also existed in other mammals during this period, including East African chimpanzees, Bornean orangutans, Central Indian macaques, cheetahs, and tigers. Analysis of mitochondrial DNA showed that major migrations from Africa increased explosively 60,000 to 70,000 years ago, which coincides with the timing of volcanic eruptions. Geologist Michael R. Rampino and volcanologist Stephen Self argue that the eruption caused a brief, dramatic cooling or volcanic winter, which resulted in a drop of the global mean surface temperature by 3 to 5 degrees Celsius, 5.4 to 9.0 degrees Fahrenheit. As a result, glaciers in the northern hemisphere have grown larger. The United Kingdom was again mostly covered by glaciers. In addition, the Fennoscandinavian ice sheet extends to present-day Poland's borders. Scientists believe that interbreeding between Neanderthals and Denisovans occurred in the Middle East at this time. This is covered in detail in the linked video Denny with a Neanderthal mother and a Denisovan father. I'd like you to please click this link for reference. Temperatures warmed up again 45,000 years ago. By this time, the European ice sheet had mainly melted except for parts of Norway. This is a critical point in the history of Homo sapiens migration. Because it was the first time they set foot in Europe, the European lands occupied by the Neanderthals will be shared with modern humans. Therefore, resources shared by the two groups in the same habitat may have needed more. Eventually, after 10,000 to 15,000 years, Neanderthals disappeared, leaving only 2% of their genes. For more information, please see the video Neanderthals and the First European linked at the top right. 40,000 years ago, the Earth started to cool again. And from about 35,000 years ago, the Laurentide ice sheet starts to get bigger. Finally, around 33,000 years ago, the last glacial period of the Quaternary glaciation began. It seems to have been the most challenging time for Neanderthals and Denisovans, who live mainly in Europe and Central Asia. They become extinct by this time, leaving Homo sapiens alone on Earth. The northern hemisphere ice sheets of the last glacial period reached maximum coverage between 26,500 and 19,000 years ago. This time we call the last glacial maximum, LGM. During the LGM, the sea level was up to 125 meters lower than it is today. Homo sapiens is the only hominin species to survive this period. People who lived during this period are called Aurignacians. We are better known as Cro-Magnons. Dot on the screen is where they lived to escape the cold. They created murals in the Chauvet Cave and statues such as the Lion Man of Hohenstein-Städel or the Venus of Hohe Fels. A 2005 study estimated the population of Upper Paleolithic Europe from 40 to 30,000 years ago was 1,738 to 28,359. For information on the population of Europe during the Aurignacian period, see the video Aurignacians and Population of Europe in Ice Age. So far, I have briefly introduced the long history of the Quaternary glaciation. In the following video, we will introduce geography during the LGM period. Please give a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications.